Good afternoon, children.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
My USB got corrupted, so I had to copy from the mobile to the other USB. That is why it took a little extra time. So we'll continue. Previous period, we were discussing the sample paper released by CBSE. A few questions we discussed. I think a few more are there. So first, we'll complete that and then we'll proceed with chapter-wise questions from different question banks. Children, when 50 questions are there, the total marks will be 40, because in the marking or in the question paper pattern itself, it is given that out of 24, first 20, then again section B out of 24, 20, then from the 12 questions, you need to attempt 10. So total 50. So 50 into 0.8, all questions are carrying equal marks. So it will be 40. But in chemistry, I saw that it's 35. In section C, they need to attempt only 5 questions. So the number of questions they need to attempt is less. So that I will again verify and let you know. But as of now, from this pattern or from this sample question paper, what they have given us, you need to attempt 50 questions, 40 marks, 90 minutes, no? 90 minutes. 90 minutes, 50 questions. Out of 60 and 40 marks, each carrying 0.8. Now we'll proceed with the next question. Question number 42. Total number of nucleotide sequences of DNA that codes for a hormone is 1530. The proportion of different bases in the sequence is found to be adenine 34%, guanine 19%, cytosine 23%, thymine 19%. Applying Chargaff's rule, what conclusion can be drawn? It's a double-stranded circular DNA. It is a single-stranded DNA. It's a double-stranded linear DNA. It's a single-stranded DNA coiled on histones. So think and answer. And the next one also I will say, 43rd question. That also you need some time to work it out. A stretch of euchromatin is having 200 nucleosomes. You have learned the formula for all these. How many base pairs will be there in that stretch with the 200 nucleosomes? And what would be the length of the typical euchromatin? You can take a few minutes to complete both. And once you have completed, do let me know. Once you complete, you can tell me. Got it? Second question anybody got? 42nd one.
Single strand.
Why single stranded? What is the reason?
It's not following.
Because how much ever is adenine, thymine should be same, and whatever is guanine, same percentage should be cytosine. But here it is not like that. So different percentage. So that indicates it is just a single stranded DNA. It cannot be double stranded. So B is the correct option. 42nd one. B is the correct option. Okay. Now the next one. A stretch of euchromatin. That anybody got? Anybody got the answer? Apply the formula. First of all, you should find out how many base pairs are present in each nucleosome. Here we have 200 nucleosome. So first of all, find out how many are present in each nucleosome. Then you already know the formula to find out the length of DNA. Tell me how many base pairs are in a single nucleosome, children? In a single one nucleosome?
200.
So one nucleosome, 200 base pairs. Here, how many nucleosome? 200. 200 nucleosome is there. So, what will be the total number of base pairs? 200 into 200. What will be the answer? Say
40,000.
Now, when this is 40,000, here again we have two options. Either it can be C or D. And how to find out the length? What is the formula to find out the length? Number of base pairs into number of base pairs into the length or the distance between two consecutive base pairs. That will not change. That is fixed. 0.34 into 10 raised to 9. So if you multiply, you will get 13,600. So the correct option is C. So those formulae, the different formulae you are learning, you should be thorough with. Once again, I will repeat. Each nucleosome, 200 nucleosomes are there. Each nucleosome is having 200 base pairs. So total number of base pairs will be 200 into 200. That is 40,000. Now, finding out the length. Length of a DNA segment is equal to total number of base pairs into the distance between two consecutive base pairs. That is the formula. And number of base pairs you already found out, 40,000. And the distance between two base pairs is 0.34 into 10 raised to 9. So when you multiply 40,000 into 0.34, you get 13,600 into 10 raised to minus 9. Got it? No? No doubt? No? So we are moving on to the next one. Observe structures of A and B given below. which of the following elements, sorry, which of the following statements are correct? So several statements are given. You have to tell which is the correct statement. Two figures are given. Can you identify these figures? What does these indicate, children? Once you identify, you will get the answer also easily. First one, what is represented there? First figure. Hello? Can anybody answer? Two sugar molecules are given. Which sugar you have to say? When I gave you the clue, also you're not able to say after giving the clue. Two sugar molecules. Which are the two sugar molecules that you need to learn? Pentose sugar, two pentose sugars, which are they? Vidur. Which are the two pentose sugars that you need to learn? Children. Vidur, somebody said statue. You're not even moving. I asked you something. Even if you don't know, you can say. Chefi, which are the two sugars? About what are you learning mainly in this chapter? Which are the two genetic material? Rijas?
RNA.
RNA has got which sugar? What is the expansion of RNA? After learning or hearing the whole Ramayana, yes? Okay, so which is the sugar present in RNA? Somebody said it.
Ribose
sugar. And in DNA?
Deoxyribose
sugar. Which one is ribose and which one is deoxyribose? If you see the lower part of these two representations, you will understand. Deoxy. DE means removal. DE is removal. Deoxy. One oxygen atom is removed. Where is one oxygen lacking? Where is one oxygen less here?
B.
A or B? A or B?
B.
B. So here one oxygen is not there. So this is deoxyribose. And this one is ribose sugar. Now we will see the remaining points. A is having. So you have to tell me which statement is correct. A is having. Which of the following statements are correct? Okay. A is having 2' OH group, which makes it less reactive and structurally stable. Whereas B is having 2' H group, which makes it more reactive and unstable. B, A is having 2' OH group, which makes it more reactive and structurally unstable. Whereas B is having 2' H group, which makes it less reactive and structurally stable. A and B both have hydroxyl groups, which make it more reactive and structurally stable. A and B both are having hydroxyl groups, which make it less reactive and structurally stable. Which is the correct one? Which one is correct? No answer is correct. Yes?
B
is the correct answer. You know that, children, just a minute. Let me scroll it down. Sorry, scroll it down here. Children, here it is. You know that this is ribose and this one is deoxyribose. Already I have learned which one is more stable and which is less stable. Which is more stable, DNA or RNA? Which is more stable?
DNA.
In this, A is having 2' OH group, which makes it less reactive. So there itself you can rule it out because it is more reactive. Ribose sugar is present in RNA. That is more reactive and unstable when compared to DNA. So first one anyway, it cannot be the correct option. Now we'll move to the C, because B, now you know it is the correct answer. Both are having hydroxyl group. That is true. Here also and here also hydroxyl groups are there, which make it more reactive and structurally stable. When something is reactive, more reactive, it will be unstable. When it is reactive, more reactive means it will be unstable. It is subjected to variations or changes. So anyway, this cannot be correct. Which makes it less reactive and structurally stable. A and B both are having hydroxyl groups, which make it less reactive. A is more reactive than B. So both are not equally less reactive. But now see the B option. A is having hydroxyl group at the 2' position, which makes it more reactive and structurally unstable. You know that point is correct. It is because of the additional OH group, it is becoming more reactive and unstable. Whereas B is having 2' H group instead of OH, which is making it less reactive. So the correct answer is B. Okay. Now the next one. If you have any doubts, I'm ready to explain. You should tell me, only then I'll come to know. This will take some time for you to do. You have to work it out. Okay? And even if you search in net also, you will not find the answer for this. Because these are questions specially prepared for you. Okay? If you try, if you want also, you cannot find it out from. Because you have to work it out. And you can refer your textbook or your notes, only then you will be able to do. You might have forgotten all those. If Michelson-Stahl's experiment is continued for 6th generations in bacteria, we have learned up to 2 generations you had learned. Now with that, you have to work out up to 6 generations and find out the ratio of heavy is to intermediate is to light. I will give you some time. You can do. You can work it out. It will take some time. You can check what happens, or after the second generation, how you have to use some figures or symbolic representation. Only then you will be able to solve it out. You cannot calculate it mentally. You have to work it out. See, after the first generation, all were of hybrid density. You know what is meant by hybrid density? Heavy and light. After first generation, then after second generation, what will happen? They'll get separated. This one, and then the blue one will get separated. Now, what is available? Only light one. Only light is available. Light I have represented using orange and heavy with blue color. Now, they are grown in a medium having light nitrogen. So what is available? There is no way to get heavy one. Only light is available here afterwards. So what will happen? They will So here all were of all of intermediate density after one generation. All were of intermediate density means mixed up, heavy and light combined, intermediate density. After the second generation, 1:1 ratio. 1:1 ratio, that is intermediate as well as the light one. In the equal ratio, 1:1. One light is to one intermediate. In that ratio, you got after second generation. Now you have to work out third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. Let me see whether anybody will be able to solve it out. Anybody got? In third generation, what you need to know? You have to separate the strands. Okay, I'll just give you a clue how to do. See now, the third generation. The third generation, where I will show, here I will show the third generation. Okay, in third generation, that blue, the all will get, it will get unwound. So that blue will get separated from that orange colored one. Blue indicate heavy, then again this also will get unwound. Okay, now the complementary, newly formed complementary strand will be of only orange color, because orange indicates light. They are in a medium containing light, so again no more blue strands will come, only our orange colored strands. Now you can find out the ratio. Okay, you will be able to find out the ratio from this. Again work out fourth generation, unwind all of them, again work it out, and again fifth generation, then sixth generation. Nobody is giving me the answer. Yes. Tanya was saying something. What is the correct option? C. All got the same answer. C. Any other answer? Any other answer?
Ma'am, just doing.
Okay. So I think I will use the EC board and I will show you. Let me see what are the answers you are getting. Then we can use the EC board and do. Because here the space is less. Can you see, wait a minute. Can you see the board?
Yes, ma'am.
EC board, can you see? Yes.
Okay.
Gayatri, did you finish doing?
Ma'am, I got D.
D. Okay, we'll do it. When all have finished doing, then we can try it out. Let me know whether if all have finished. Nandana is not there. Okay, all should do, only then we can find out. See, first generation. Those who haven't understood. So after the first generation, so here what we are doing is from heavy medium. So these bacteria were grown in heavy medium and then they are brought to lighter medium. So they have no other source of nitrogen, only light one is available. So light I will represent using orange, and blue I will use for representing heavy ones. So after first generation, you already know that they will be of intermediate density. So I'm just taking just one example. Just one DNA. So after first generation, you already know that they are of intermediate density. Let it be red so that you can see it clearly. This is after first generation. Now second generation. In second generation, what will happen? These will unwind. They have to unwind. So red, the other one will be blue. Now they are grown in a medium, so the medium is having only light nitrogen. N14 only is available, so they can form which one I told you as light green, or I think heavy I showed as red. No, light is blue. Light is blue, and heavy I'm showing it is orange or red color. So they are grown in a medium having light nitrogen. So new strands will be of blue color. I'll be showing with blue color. There is no possibility of getting orange color. Why? Because these bacteria are grown in a medium where only light nitrogen is the source. And you know that nitrogen is needed for the synthesis of DNA. So newly synthesized one will be of blue color. We have no other option, only this. So here you can see after second generation, light and intermediate will be in the equal ratio. Here if you take more number also, you will get proportionate number here. 2:2 or 3:3. So each one will be, this is in the same ratio, 1:1 ratio. That is the second generation. Now if you proceed to third generation, okay, third generation. So this one will unwind. This also will unwind. One will be red. Now they have unwound. Now again the replication process taking place. No, so they should form new complementary strand. So that all will be, I will be showing in blue color because only light is available. No heavy nitrogen, so it cannot be of the other color. Again continuing, if anywhere you're not following, ask me to stop and repeat. So what will be the ratio here, children? If it is intermediate, light to intermediate, then the ratio will be 3:1. Am I right? 3:1. Again, each one will be unwinding. Now all the new strands will be formed, will be lighter one. So again I am using blue coloring. What will be the ratio? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7, no? 1, 2, 3, 4, 7:1. Did you get the same after fourth generation? Sorry, third generation. Gayatri?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it 7:1 that you got?
Oh, yes, ma'am.
after third generation to know whether I have made any mistakes. Now again these are going to be unwound. Okay, so from here, so here we have four. I'll just draw it here again. Or third generation, I'm just drawing here again. One next one, then again three more. Okay, each one will be separated and forming a new complementary strand. So what will happen from here? We will get again how many new DNA? How many you will get children from these three? Are you there, children? Michael, how many we will get from three? Three DNA strands are undergoing replication. How many we will get now? Louder.
Six.
This also will form eight. And from here also you will get two strands. One will be out of this, one will be intermediate and another one will be lighter one, because this is unwinding. One is red, one is blue. This I just doubled and wrote here. It will unwind and form like this, and the new strand will be like this. So altogether 6 plus 8 14. 15 is to somewhere, something went wrong, I think. 15 is to 14, 15. 15 is to 2. Okay. Now, again, if it is continued, how many we will get?
15 is to 1.
Ah, okay, 1. Sorry. So 15 is to 1. Correct. 15 is to 1. Only one intermediate strand. Now, in the next step, this is which generation? Fourth generation. Fifth generation. What you will get? Fifth generation. This was first, second, third. Okay, fourth, fifth one, no? Now, sixth generation. After sixth generation, what we'll be getting? 31, no? 31 is to 1. Do not understand how it is coming? I'll just show. 1 minute. Okay. Let me take a darker color pen. See, 15 light is to 1 intermediate. That is what we got at the end of fifth generation. And in the question, it is about sixth generation. So these 15 are completely light. So rather than doing, I thought I'll just double the number, because there are no chance of getting mixed up. Those 15 light, purely light, no, it's not intermediate. So 15 light, so they will double upon replication, they will form 30 light. And what will happen to this one intermediate? One intermediate means one will be blue and the other one is red. So when they separate, what we'll be getting? One intermediate and one completely light one. So new strand formed will be like this. So this plus one. So 31 light and one intermediate. And what they have asked in the question? What they have asked? What is the question? Somebody read. You have it with you? Have you noted down, children? Or else I will read. Wait. Nobody is having the question. Now, if you have, you can read. Question yes. number? It was question number?
45.
45. You have to find out the ratio of heavy strand is to hybrid strand is to light strand. Heavy hybrid, that I'll write as intermediate. Intermediate is to light. Heavy, any strands are completely heavy, both strands are red. We didn't get any such DNA. So that will be zero. How many intermediate? One. How many light? 31. So the correct option is D. Did you understand? How did you get it? So same way it can be like, again, it can be asked at the end of the seventh generation. So you don't have to unwind and figure it out like this. So suppose if it is seventh generation, how can you easily calculate? See, seventh generation. At the end of sixth generation, we have. At the end of sixth generation, we are having 31 light and one intermediate. So what is the easy method to find it out? This 31 will be doubled. So it will be 62. And then this one intermediate means that will again produce, it will unwind. So it will unwind. And this is what is going to form. Again, it will form one intermediate and one light. So from that, you can add one to here. So 63 light and one intermediate. Again, if you want to find out the eighth generation, here also you can use the same method. Eighth generation, 63, double of this, 126 light. And from this one intermediate, you will be getting one light and one intermediate. One light and one intermediate. So that light you can add with this. So 127 is to one intermediate. Have you understood? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
I don't know. Those who haven't attended the classes regularly, I really doubt. You check this because... the same way they can ask 7th, 8th, 9th generation, we don't know. Maybe 3rd generation. So such questions can come. So if you don't know how this is happening, then it will be difficult. Why all the strands, newly formed strands, I have shown in blue color. Blue color indicates light. Why only light in nitrogen I was using? Because those bacteria which were grown in heavy medium were transferred to light medium. So further replications are taking place only in the light medium. Light medium means light nitrogen. So even if they want, they cannot have heavy already what is existing in their body that is there with heavy DNA. But whenever, you know that when it is multiplying, when it is replicating or when it is undergoing division, when the new DNA is formed, for forming the new DNA, the source of nitrogen is only light. That is why for all the newly formed DNA, I have represented it using light color. So if you haven't understood, just learn that Matthew Michelson's experiment. And then if you check this question, it will be easy for you to understand.
In the question, it is not said that from the heavy medium, it's transferred to the light medium.
That there in the beginning, what they have said about Matthew Michelson, they have mentioned, no. So that is understood. If Matthew Michelson's and Stahl's experiment is continued for six generations, so the question is asked with the impression that you know, like hearing the name of the experiment, name of the scientist, you should know what is the experiment they were doing. I told all the experiments are important. So many experiments you are learning. So from that itself, you should understand what is carried out in that experiment. What happened in the first generation, what happened in the second generation, till there it is in the textbook. Okay, so hearing that experiment or seeing that name of the scientist, you should be able to understand that so and so things have happened. Okay, so you understood that the questions are not that easy as you think. This is just I found that these questions are easy. More difficult questions we'll see, like case study, reasoning questions. So take a little more seriously. Next class when you come, you revise structure of DNA. Maybe we'll be doing other questions also, because it is not topic wise. We have got the question banks chapter wise. So we'll try to pick out those questions which are based on like structure and replication. Don't learn transcription. Including replication, you revise and come, and each one can frame how many questions? 2 questions are enough. Okay, 5 questions. I think we will not get time to discuss. Okay, you write it on a paper or Microsoft Word somewhere you type, so that you can immediately. Otherwise, you can. It will take time, so we can share the screen. Maybe randomly only I might call. Okay, whosoever names are called, they can share their Microsoft Word or PDF or whatever it is. You type 2 questions over there, and we can share and we can try to answer that. Agree? Revise up to transcription. Shall we wind up? And I'm seeing some of the absentees over here, children. How many times I told how much importance? See, 14 out of 21. Now, when we are doing all these, if you're not cooperating, I don't know. Nidhi, Nia, majority of the classes, I don't know, may God save them. Then, Nevin, same people, same students are being absent. Mehak, but still some are there. Evelyn, Evelyn is there. Then, Sharon, not there. I don't know, I have been repeating this several times, but you're not understanding the seriousness. Children, you don't understand the importance of many of these questions. All these, once you're listening, no, it will get stored over there. And when you see the question paper, you can recollect, it will come. If you are concentrating properly, all these will come to your mind when you see the question paper. And that just by reading, you understood that just by reading or making the topics thorough, you're not able to, you will not be able to score marks. Only by repeated trying out of such questions only you will be thorough with all that. So please tell your friends to attend the classes. So thank you, children. So next class, do revise and come.